have venom to its people. We're better off trying to fight and get a positive attitude going and trying to bring people together. The Charlie Zoo.
It has nothing to do with venom, Aaron. Whenever somebody gets exposed for what they are, somebody comes up and says, oh, why can't we all play together, you know, like Rodney King? That's bullshit. I gotta tell you that right now. It's absolute crap. Exposing people in this movement for what they really are and instead of what they pretend to be is exactly what has to be done. You see, all this 10th Amendment resolution stuff that Charlie Duke started and was going across the country had a lot of people pigeonholed, chasing their tails around in little cul-de-sacs for nothing. If the federal government will not obey the real 10th Amendment, which is a part of the supreme law of the land, they're not going to listen to some 10th Amendment resolution that's passed by a state that means nothing, has no teeth in the law, and has no consequence if they ignore it.
I'm sure it's
certainly
raised the consciousness of a lot of people.
Pigeonholing, doing things and spending money on a cause that is absolutely worthless. If you want to get behind a cause, get behind the Council on Domestic Relations and Jackie Petru and Dan Druck, who are really putting teeth into the 10th Amendment, and they're getting resolutions passed in states that says that if the federal government does not obey the 10th Amendment and the other parts of the Constitution, then the states are going to disenfranchise them. And then that's got the force of law. So, you know, that's what people should be. They should be involved in something that actually accomplishes something and doesn't just make some statement, you know, blowing in the wind.
Well, I think that's what I like about America. We're all on top of their own opinion, Bill. You know, I think Charlie did a good job.
You know what? I'm hearing stuff from you I never heard before.
What's that?
And it doesn't sit well with me.
What's that? What are you hearing you never heard before?
Well, you know, you started the Constitution Party and got that going, and you left the Constitution Party. Charlie Duke and some of his buddies came in and tried to destroy the Constitution Party.
That was a pretty good job of it.
Well, you can say that all you want, but you know damn well that I called you and told you exactly what was happening and sent you faxes of all of the stuff.
Yes.
And so don't tell me you don't know what was happening to do. Now you've got him in your video.
Wait a second. Don't put words in my mouth. I never said I didn't know what happened. I said I wasn't a part of what happened. And I only knew peripherally from what you told me.
You don't have to be a part of it.
Charlie Duke, I never spoke to Karen. I was never involved in the inner workings of what was going on after I left with that. And the fact that you have a bone to pick with Charlie Duke, that's between you and Charlie Duke. It's got nothing to do with me. I like Charlie Duke. I think he's a decent guy.
And it does have something. It has a lot to do with you. The whole thing started when they made accusations that you stole money from the Constitution Party, so don't pull this crap with me. Who the hell do you think you are?
No, because I don't agree with you, I don't think I'm anything. You can't force stuff down my throat, because I think Charlie Duke has done an admirable job. He may have screwed up with the Freeman. I don't know exactly what happened. But the man has brought a certain consciousness to people, and I don't resent the guy. I don't dislike the guy, and you can't make me say that I do. And that's why America's a free country.
That's not what I'm saying.
What are you saying? What are you saying? Because I don't agree with you.
No, you said you weren't a part of it. The whole thing started when they accused you of stealing money from the Constitution Party. You remember that?
Bill, excuse me. You told me no one ever said that to me. You told me that.
I sent you the communications from them that made those accusations.
And no one ever said that. No one ever accused me of that to my face. And you know that, and I know that. The only thing I ever had was that you said that.
You know, Aaron, I'm sorry that I spent all the time defending you over that and took all the flack that I did and spent all the time trying to keep the party together.
Sorry.
When you obviously don't even give a damn.
You're sorry that you defended me because I did the truth? You're sorry that you defended the truth? Is that what you're saying?
You're telling me that doesn't mean anything because nobody accused you to your face.
If you're sorry you defended the truth, then nobody should get behind you.
No, that's not what it's about.
You just said you're sorry you defended you.
No, that's not what I said, Aaron.
Exactly what you said.
No.
Dude,
no. What I said is I'm extremely disappointed.
Come on.
You.
No, don't be a bully.
Good night, Aaron. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't get behind this. It sounds like Aaron's doing the same thing again, and as soon as the money starts coming in and all that kind of stuff, sounds to me like he's going to bail out just like he bailed out on the Constitution Party. I can't get behind it. He's the one that uncovered, to me, Charlie Duke's real politics. When the Constitution Party began to get strong, Sharon Ford, Karen Scarborough, and Charlie Duke mounted an attempt to destroy the Constitution Party, and they did a pretty good job of it. and it began by accusing Aaron Russo of stealing funds. I spent my own money to make an audit of all of the books of the Constitution Party. I defended Aaron Russo. I took all the flack and all the blame for everything that was happening because he had bailed out, and then they began to accuse me. And now Aaron wants to start some other thing and get all people into it if you buy a videotape. Sorry, folks. Sounds like the same old routine to me. And it really makes me angry. He sent me a video and said, this is the video we're selling. I watched it. Charlie Duke was not on that video. And if he had been, we wouldn't have done this broadcast tonight. Now he's telling me that what they're selling is a videotape with Charlie Duke on there, somebody that Aaron Russo could not have endorsed before when he was the chairman of the Constitution Party. And so, folks, cut me out of it. I'm sorry that I had him on as a guest tonight. I'm sorry that I subjected you to all of this. If you want to join that, and if you want to send him $20, go right ahead. And if you want to send $5 a month, go right ahead with that, too. But I can't approve of it, can't get behind it. I think there was a little deception in getting on the air tonight. I think Aaron Russo knows exactly what he's saying about Charlie Duke. And maybe that's why he sent me the videotape that did not have Charlie Duke on it. I am extremely angry right now. Good night. I hope you can all sort this out. And God bless you all.
To hear from you, write Cagi, C-A-J-I, Box 1420, Sholo, spelled S-H-O-W-L-O-W, Arizona 8590.